Dr. Rana. Good morning, good afternoon, or maybe good evening from wherever you're watching from. I'm Dr. Pauline Gacheri from Kenya. I'm practicing clinical dermatology here. I have an interest also in dermatoscopy, which is part definitely of clinical dermatology. And I did a fellowship in aesthetic medicine with ILAMED, and I'm really enjoying practicing in that branch of aesthetic medicine too. So today we look at dermatoscopic beyond skin cancers. And basically a dermatoscope is a device with high magnification lenses and inbuilt illumination system that helps us to see beyond the skin surface. It's very popular, especially in the Western countries, to identify melanocytic lesions as well as other skin cancers. But of late, the indications are expanding, and very soon I bet I will be calling it a dermatologist telescope. And we are moving towards a clinical dermatoscopic pathological correlation. And I'm actually looking forward to a time where all dermatologists and in extension, general practitioners or even in other fields are going to own a stethoscope and make it a routine to place a stethoscope in almost all skin lesions for us to even be able to differentiate from other differential diagnoses by seeing beyond what you just see on the skin surface. Dermatoscopy patterns in skin of color, especially African skins, is still lacking. And we hope with time, if we are to embrace use of a dermatoscope, this is going to be bridged. So essentially, we have two types of dermatoscopes. We have a polarized dermatoscope and an unpolarized sort of light dermatoscope. And the difference here is that when you're using an unpolarized light, you actually don't see deeper into the skin surface. As you can see here on the second picture, this is an unpolarized light. So we have the light source here. And when light is on the skin surface, when the light settles on the skin surface, a lot happens, reflection, refraction, and we have light in all directions. And when you place a glass plate or an oil or liquid interface between the dermatoscope and the skin, you're able to see below. You know, it allows the light to go below, but at the same time, a lot is still reflected and you perceive a lot from the skin surface. But when you're using a polarized light, it has a cross-polarizing filters that actually will filter most of the light that is being reflected from the skin surface. And then you're able to see, as you can see here with the black line, you're able to see the light that go deeper than the skin surface, in this case, beyond the epidermis and all the way to the papillary dermis here. There's a lot of physics on light dermatoscopy, and this is just a simple presentation of the same. The colors in dermatoscopy, so I think we've all seen, I'm assuming, we've all seen as a histological picture of the skin. Here we can see the same. So you have the epidermis and you have the dermis. So the epidermis, you can see the layers of the epidermis, that is the cornea, you have the granulosa layer, you have the spinosus and the basal layer with the retinal ridges, and then we have the papillary dermis, and deeper we have the reticular dermis. It's good to appreciate the colors that a dermatoscope reveals when you're using one. Usually when it's black, it denotes melanin, mostly on the stratum corneum or the uppermost layer of the skin. If it shows more brown, it's melanin still, but likely deeper into the epidermis, was the dermoepidermal junction. A gray, still melanin, but way deeper into the dermis. Sometimes you can see blue color. When you see orange, yellowish color, most of the time is the keratin, or sometimes even crusts. When you see white color, most of the time is either scarring, mostly on the surface of the skin, or even deeper, or fibrosis. You know, here we have collagen and all that. That will all show as white on dermatoscope. And then the blood vessels will show more of red color. So dermatoscopy use in general dermatology, we go there, we dive directly into that. And we start with scabies. Scabies is a common, highly contagious ectoparasitosis. Infested individual will have a number of mites, 10 to 15, but can get to almost a million in, say, Norwegian or crested scabies. The female mites that are big actually than the male mites dig burrows or tunnel-like through the stratum corneum, and they lay 2 to even up to 5 eggs in a day. And the clinical presentation is actually pruritus, worse at night, and this is due to the hypersensitivity to the saliva, eggs, and even the feces of the mice. So microscopy identification, you can see the mice, eggs, and feces when you do a skin scraping. This is a standard technique, actually. The mite has a pigmented anterior part, and the two pairs of legs show under the microscope as a pigmented part. On dermatoscopy, this is said to be jet-like or a delta, or more commonly a triangular structure. It is visualized at the end of a burrow as a contrail-shaped segment. The burrow shows as a contrail-shaped segment, and at the end, then you see the triangular structure. And those able to do video dermoscopy, you can actually see the mites move in the burrows, and you can appreciate the eggs and feces even more. Using a simple handheld dermatoscope at even 10 magnification with an oil interface, you're able to see this shape. Sometimes you can have difficulty in identifying, especially in hairy individual, when there is a secondary infection. Here we can see a picture of this is actually a picture of a mite, of a scabies mite. So the part that is appreciated under the dermatoscope is this part, the mouth part, and the first two pairs of legs. And this is a schematic presentation of the same, whereby this part, the anterior part, shows like the triangle, and then the burrows that are made under the skin, under the stratum corneum, is seen as this translucent contrail, more of like a jet on the sky. This is a pigmented skin. This black arrow actually shows this triangular structure. Then the rest of the body is somehow translucent, but then you can see the burrow of the same. Here is fecal matter. I think it's not very clear with the zoom. Here is another presentation of the same in the burrow. And these ovalish translucent structures are actually eggs, the mite eggs. These are other examples, this shows different stages of treatment. Here is before the treatment, and you can see the structure here. You can see the structure here, but then as you do topical treatment, the structure just disappears as the mite disintegrates. So dermatoscopy in that case can be used to evaluate the treatment of scabies. So the other